السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته سامعين وحضرات. In this last episode of the season first, we shall just witness that how the revelation of Quranic ayats begins on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we shall just witness that how Jibreel alayhi salam meets Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So first we shall start with the narration of Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha. Aisha radhiyallahu ta'ala anha narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, before the revelation began, he began to seclude himself in the cave of Hira. Around this time, other things also started to happen. In the hadith in Sahih Muslim, he said that before the revelation came to me, I began to hear the rocks and the stones greet me in my path. I would hear the rocks and stones saying salam to me. And there was a particular rock that always gave salam to me, and I recognize it to this day in Makkah. I know exactly which rock that was. Every single night, he began having a dream about what would happen the next day. He would mention this to Khadija. Oh Khadija, I am seeing the dreams, and every time I see a dream, that comes true next day. And Khadija consoled him and said that this is good sign from Allah. And it is mentioned in Bukhari as well, and this period of dreams. Hadith in Sahih Muslim says that when somebody asked him, why do we fast on Mondays, Ya Rasulullah? So the Prophet said, on a Monday I was born, and on a Monday I got revelation. So the revelation began in the last 10 days of Ramzan on a Monday. That day marks for us Laylatul Qadr. And as I said, there are some reports that Saturday and Sunday he had something else. Then on Monday occurs the famous incident that all of us know. We tell it to our children that when he was sitting in the cave of Hira, the Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel, came to him and told him Iqra. So the Prophet said, I cannot read. So the Jibreel took him and squeezed him so tight. The Prophet said, I cannot read, I lost all my energy. Then he let me go again, and then he said to me again, Iqra, and from a clinging substance, recite, and your Lord is the most generous. Who taught you by pain, taught man that which he knew not. So when Jibreel alayhi salam told Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Iqra, the Prophet understood to read from a paper. So he responded back, I cannot read, I don't know how to read. So he again tells him to him that recite, and so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only understands reading. So he goes, I don't know how to read. So for the third time, when he says this, now Jibreel tells him, I'm not asking you to read from a paper. No, your recitation will come directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from a paper. Your recitation will be in the name of Allah, and will the blessings of Allah, and communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet returned back to Khadija. He ran back to Khadija. His heart was palpitating. He entered in upon Khadija and he said to her, cover me up, cover me up. So he's terrified, his heart is palpitating, and when you are that nervous and that anxious, you get cold, and of course Khadija covers him up because you are trembling, you are scared. And when she calms him down, he tells her that the story that such and such happened to me, and I'm worried for myself. This is the phrase in Bukhari, I'm scared for myself. So Khadija responded to him, you are good to your kin, you are good to your family, you take on the burdens of other people, and you give money to those who have nothing, and you are hospitable to the guest. Immediately, when this is not the famous one that you are aware of, so that she immediately went to Adas, and Adas was a Christian slave of one of the uncles, of Khadija. Khadija first went to him and asked him if he was familiar with what is going on, because that is not something they are used to. And when he was told of this, that what the angel of God or the angel of Allah in this heathen place of idols of Makkah, idols of Makkah, how is this possible? Then according to the words reported in Bukhari Sharif later on to Waraqa ibn Nawafil, right? So Waraqa ibn Nawafil is of course Khadija's older cousin. It is my humble interpretation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best that Waraqa embraced a type of Jedi Christianity. So he is not a pure Christian or a pure Jew. So he is simply somebody who understands that these. He became agitated and he becomes eager and he says that by Allah, this is the same keeper of secrets. And it calms him, which is a keeper of secrets. This is the holiest of holy. This is the major angel that came down after Musa. How I wish I were a young man rather than an old man, so that I could help you when your nation ridicules you and your nation persecutes you and your nation will expel you. And when he said that your nation expels you, the prophet couldn't keep quiet and he says, my nation will expel me. And Waraqa says, yes, because never has any prophet been sent except that his people ridiculed him, persecuted him and expelled him, and you are not going to be any different. And Aisha radhiyallahu anha says that he only lived a short time until he passed away. And later on, some of the relatives of Waraqa asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that what is the face of Waraqa, and the Prophet said that he saw Waraqa wearing white robes and having been blessed with gardens in Jannah. The Prophet went on in telling the story because he is the one narrating, and then he says that revelation stopped to come. I didn't see Jibreel for a while. Ibn Abbas says that for many days the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would wander around Makkah and the valleys of Makkah and the mountains of Makkah, wanting to see Jibreel again. A few months Jibreel did not come, did not return to earth again. And also, so the Prophet is resumed a little back to normal. And then the Prophet is narrating this hadith, is also in Bukhari, that when I was walking about my way, I heard a sound, and this is the second revelation, that I looked up in the heavens and I saw the same angel that had come upon to me in here. I sat on a throne, I was sitting on a rock that was in the heavens and the earth, and once again I trembled, I got scared. So I began to palpitate and I rushed back to Khadija again saying, and that was when Jibreel came and revealed the second revelation, the seven verses of Surah Mudassir. O you who is wrapped up in garments, O you who is covered up in the cloak, stand up and warn the people. Stand up and warn the people. With Iqra, they say he became a Nabi, and with the Surah Mudassir, they say he became a Rasul. This is how right from the birth to the time of revelation, 0 to 40 years of old. Now the Prophet became 40 years of old. And after this season, in next season, we shall continue with next 8 episodes. Till that time, please like, share this video and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much from Combo Pro.